हेलो चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू एम्स इंडिया ऑनलाइन क्लास बायोलॉजी सेशन अल्ट्रा स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सेल। द सेल एंड इट्स अल्ट्रा स्ट्रक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द व्हाट इज सेल, व्हाट आर इट्स पार्ट्स, व्हाट आर इट्स फंक्शंस एंड द डेफिनेशन। वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एस्पेक्ट्स रिगार्डिंग cell, living cell. Okay, so here the picture itself, see the different organelles, mitochondria, vacuole, chloroplast, cell membrane, cell wall, cytoplasm, ribosomes, nucleus. This is a plant cell. Okay, so let us proceed. Cell is the fundamental structural and functional unit of living organisms. Why cell is the structural and functional unit of all living organisms? The meaning is, it is the definition of cell. Without cell, there is no organ system. Without cell, there is no organ. Okay, so it is the structural component of each and every organ of living organism. Hence it is called the structural unit. Then functional unit. Why it is the functional unit? So every function which is carried out by an organism is also carried at cellular level. That's why cell is the functional unit. So we can define cell as the fundamental structural and functional unit of all living organisms. Okay, let us study how. The science which deals with the cells and their organelles, it is called cell biology. The science which deals with the cells and their organelles is called cell biology. The term cell was first used by Robert Hooke, name of the scientist who used the term cell for the first time in 1665, and he described the cell first as cella, C-E-L-L-A, cella. The meaning of it is hollow space. Robert Hooke, for the first time in 1665, used the term cell, and he proposed that, he gave the term cella, which means hollow space. He studied cork tissue under the microscope, dead cork tissue, and he proposed that the tissue is made up of several compartments, and each compartment he called it as a cella, which is a hollow space. The meaning is, Robert Hooke observed the cells in the section of cork and introduced the term cella. Let us proceed. Cell theory. The history of cell science was started in the year 1665 by the discovery of cell by Robert Hooke. Okay, later in 1831 Robert Brown observed nucleus in plant cells. Later in 1858 Rudolf Virchow stated that new cells arise from pre-existing cells. Who said that new cells arise from pre-existing cells? Rudolf Virchow. The meaning is omnis cellulae cellula. Omnis cellulae cellula. The meaning is the new cells exist from or arise from pre-existing cells. Next, Schleiden, a German botanist, in 1938 In 1938, Schleiden, a German botanist, described cell theory with regard to plant cell. Okay, Schleiden is a botanist. Botanist means who study about the plants. In 1938, he described cell theory with regard to plant cell. And Theodor Schwann, a German zoologist, both of them belongs to different countries, different subject. Zoologist means who study about the animals. Okay, in 1939, he described cell theory with regard to animal cells. Okay, Schleiden, a botanist, studied the plant cells and proposed cell theory. Schwann, zoologist, he described the cell theory with regard to animal cells. So both of them put forward the cell theory. Both of them ideas are same. Schleiden proposed that all plants are made up of structural units called cells. Schwann proposed that all animals are made up of structural units called cells. Okay, cell theory denotes that cell is the structural and functional unit of life. Okay, cell is the structural and functional unit of life according to cell theory. Who proposed cell theory? Schleiden and Schwann together. Okay, and this point was also included in that cell theory. Cells arise from pre-existing cells, which was said by Rudolf Virchow, was also included in that cell theory. Okay, let us proceed. Shape of the cell. The shape of the cells is variable. Means we can't say this is the particular shape. It may be of different shapes. Different cells have different shapes. See here the spindle shape muscle cell, okay, and bone cells oval shape, nerve cell long tubular, okay, so different shapes, it's a fat cell, and the body cells WBC, different shape, a spermatozoa, male gamete, a ova, female gamete. So different cells, that's why the shape of the cells is variable. The cells of unicellular forms means only single cell, like leukocytes means WBC, and bacteria exhibit number of shapes. Number of shapes means, for example, a bacteria, some spherical bacteria, spiral bacteria, okay, rod shaped bacteria, oval shaped bacteria, different shapes, isn't it? Next, the shapes like rounded, cylindrical, irregular, triangular and tubular shape, different shapes. There are millions of living organisms in nature. They have different shapes, sizes, and varying number of cells they contain. Okay, there are millions of living organisms are there in the nature. Plants, animals, microorganisms, so many. So they have different shapes and sizes, and they vary, the number of cells also vary from one organism to another organism. Okay, there are unicellular organisms and multicellular organisms are present in the nature. So various cells here in the image which we have seen, these are all the cells which are present in the human beings. Our body is composed of different types of cells. See, nerve cell is different shape, cell of the muscle is different shape, fat cells are different shape, blood corpuscles are different shape, bone cells. This is the bone cell. Osteocyte is a different shape. Okay, the shape or the structure is related to its function. Okay, let us proceed. The size of the cells. The size of the cells in living organism may be as small as the millionth of the meter. Means micron. Millionth of the meter is the micron. Or maybe as large as few centimeters. Okay. The size of the cell is also variable. See, different shapes, different sizes. Okay. This is WBC. These are all these three. RBC. Okay. Then this is some epithelial tissue. This is the ovum. This is spermatozoa. This is the muscle cell. This is the nerve cell. This is the DNA. So different shapes. Okay, the size vary from microns to centimeters. The maturity of the cell are too small to be seen with naked eyes. We cannot see. They can be seen only through a microscope. We need an external device to observe these cells. That is the microscope. The smallest cell is 0.1 to 0.5 micrometers. Okay, the smallest cell is 0.1 to 0.5 micrometers. It is found in bacteria. It is found in bacteria. Pleuropneumonia-like organisms, they are called. PPLO. Pleuropneumonia-like organisms, the smallest cells. The nerve cell found in the mammals may reach a length of 3 or 3.5 feet. Means the largest cell lengthwise. The smaller cells are those of the pleuropneumonia-like organisms. The pleuropneumonia-like organism 0.1 to 0.5 micrometers. Pleuropneumonia-like organisms, PPLO. They are the smallest. Largest cell is nerve cell, neuron. Okay. Next. The structure of the cell. The plasma membrane. So here the structure, in common structures we are going to discuss. If you take cells are divided into different types based on the structure of nucleus. They are prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells means the cells with primitive nucleus or without nucleus. Example, bacteria. Okay, eukaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell means they are well-developed cells. The cells with well-developed nucleus. The cells with double-membraned nuclear envelope. So such cells are called eukaryotic cells. But whether it is prokaryotic cell or eukaryotic cell, this structure is common. Plasma membrane. What is plasma membrane? A porous membrane surrounds the cytoplasm called plasma membrane. Okay, this is the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane. The electron microscope studies reveals that the plasma membrane is composed of outer inner protein layers. Here, the protein layers. Outer and inner. Okay, outer and inner protein layers, and in between them double layered lipids. Here, see, this is the double layered lipids are present. So this was the model proposed by Robertson. Robertson called this membrane as unit membrane model. This model introduced by Robertson was unit membrane model. Unit membrane model, which includes a bile protein layer. In between the protein layers, a bile lipid layer is present. Okay. The main function of the plasma membrane is to regulate the entry and exit of substances. So the plasma membrane, it is useful in the transport. That is, it acts like a bridge. Anything enters into the cell, it is through plasma membrane. Anything leaves the cell, it is also through the plasma membrane. So the main function of the plasma membrane is to regulate the entry and exit of substances. Entry and exit. Next, cytoplasm. So which are the common structures in both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell? Cytoplasm and the plasma membrane. The cytoplasm is the jelly-like substance. It is the jelly-like substance present between the nucleus and cell membrane. So here, this is the nucleus and this is the cell membrane. The fluid, the jelly-like substance present between the inner nuclear membrane and outer plasma membrane, it is called the cytoplasm. Cyto means cell, within the cell. Plasm, the fluid present within the cell, is the cytoplasm. Okay. So the part of the protoplasm outside the nucleus is known as cytoplasm. Actually, protoplasm means entire content present in the cell is called protoplasm. Protoplasm minus nucleus is equal to the cytoplasm. The part of the protoplasm outside the nucleus is called cytoplasm. It is distinguished as an outer non-granular thick ectoplasm and inner granular endoplasm. Cytoplasm is equal to ectoplasm plus endoplasm. Outer non-granular means smooth, soft, thick ectoplasm and inner granular endoplasm. It contains membrane bound structures. The cytoplasm contains membrane bound structures called cell organelles. They are called cell organelles, as well as more complex chemicals. So cytoplasm contains embedded cell organelles and several chemicals, complex chemicals. The chemical composition of cytoplasm is, it contains water. Along with that, it contains macromolecules like polysaccharides or carbohydrates, proteins, hormones, and different other substances, enzymes. Enzymes are the chemical substances. The biocatalysts are also present in the cytoplasm of the cell. Okay? So as we are studying the ultrastructure of cell, means the structure which is not visible to our naked eye, when the cell is observed under the microscope, electron microscope, what are the things visible? Those we are going to discuss. We are discussing now. So here, see, it is a typical cell, plant cell, because vacuole, large vacuole is present. And see the different organelles, mitochondria, the cell wall, cell membrane, nucleus, cytoplasm. Okay? Cytoplasm is called the matrix of the cell. The jelly-like substance present between the nucleus and cell membrane, it is called cytoplasm. Cell organelles help to carry out several functions within the cell. Because in the beginning itself, cell is the structural and functional unit of all living things, all living organisms. So the cell organelles help to carry out several functions within the cell. Next, let us discuss about cell organelles. The first one, nucleus. Nucleus is the most prominent cell organelle. It is the most prominent, visible. With the help of a compound microscope also, we can clearly see the nucleus. Okay? So, the origin of cell nucleus, if you see, the nuclei initiate from pre-existing ones. Okay, nucleus is not newly formed, which is already present in the cell. Okay, when the cell divides, the nucleus also divides and the new nucleus is formed. Nucleus initiate from the pre-existing ones and are never formed afresh. During cell division, the nucleus of the mother cell divides to form daughter nucleus. Okay, so for example, a cell, a nucleus is present. So this nucleus divide along with the cell, means the mother nucleus again form the daughter nucleus. Next, in a eukaryotic cell, a definite nucleus is present and it is 5 to 25 microns in size. Eukaryotic nucleus, eukaryotic cell. What I told you, eukaryotic nucleus or eukaryotic cell nucleus means the nucleus which possesses a double-layered nuclear membrane. A two-layered nuclear membrane is present. So the size of the eukaryotic nucleus is 5 to 25 microns in size and it shows the following parts. What are they? A double-layered nuclear membrane or nuclear envelope and nuclear pores. These are the nuclear pores. And a nucleolus, a colored body, nucleolus. And a chromatin material. This is the chromatin material, the thread-like structures which is present within the nucleus, which is composed of DNA, genetic material. Okay? A nucleus is a most prominent cell organelle. It is present in the center of the cell. And a new nucleus is formed from the pre-existing nucleus during cell division. And its size is 5 to 25 microns in size. It possesses a double-layered nuclear envelope or nuclear membrane. It possesses this nuclear membrane possesses some apertures called nuclear pores. And within the nucleus, a colored body, nucleolus is present, brightly colored structure. And a diffuse thread-like structures are present in the nucleus. It is nothing but the chromatin material. Okay, children? Who discovered nucleus? Robert Brown discovered the cell nucleus. Okay, children, I hope you understood today's topic. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.